So if you remember in the last session, I had told you that the computer understands only ones and zeros. But the problem of writing code in ones and zeros is it is time consuming, extremely difficult to write as well as remove errors from the code. So in order to solve that particular problem, from machine level language, we evolved to assembly language. From assembly, we evolved to high level language. Now, in order to convert the code written in assembly to machine level language and the code written in a high level language to a machine level language or assembly language, we use various softwares. So this session is going to be about those particular softwares. So in the first part, I'm just going to discuss about the assembler, compiler and the interpreter. Subsequently, in the second video, I'll talk about the linker and the loader, what is their functions. It is especially important to understand the functioning of the linker because at a conceptual level, because when you're writing C programs, a lot of times you will get linker error and you should know why you are getting that particular error with meaningful explanation. Now, why do we need translators? I had already briefly told you about this. Computers understand only ones and zeros, or also known as the machine level language. Now, in order to write code in high level language or assembly language, we use software tools called as system softwares, which take a program written in assembly or high level language and help us convert it into machine level language. For example, if a code is written in assembly level language, the tool which converts it into machine level language is called as the assembler. In case of a high level language like C, Fortran, COBOL, C++, it is a tool called as a compiler. And in certain languages, they use a translator tool which converts high level language into an executable code known as the interpreter. Examples of languages which use interpreter are BASIC, Python, Perl and so on. So first let's try to understand what is an assembly language or what is an assembler. So assembler is again a system software. Why is it a system software? An assembler is written only for a specific hardware architecture. You cannot write an assembler for an ARM machine and expect it to work on an Intel machine or work on an, say for example, my AMD processor, because the hardware design and architecture is going to be quite different. So it's a system program that transforms symbols or code written in assembly language to machine level language. Machine level language in technical words is also known as object code. This will be more clear when we are getting into programming in C. So if you look at assembly language, I am saying move A, B. That means the contents of B are going to be copied to A. So what the assembly language will simply do is, assembly language converter, which is the assembler, will do is it will read this and convert it into machine language instructions like this. So this is the job of a assembler. Now let's try to understand the next conversion tool. So our next conversion tool I am going to talk about is going to be the compiler. So what does a compiler do? A compiler is a system software or also a computer program which translates a program written in a high level language like C, C++ into an executable for that given machine. Also, it is known as a software which converts source code. That means your code written in C, C++ to assembly or machine code. So a compiler transforms your high level language into object code or machine code. Now there are two definitions of what a compiler is. Suppose I have something like this. In a high level language, I am copying the value of B to A by doing this particular assignment. A compiler could just convert this into assembly language, and then the assembler could convert this into machine level language. Or in some compilers, all these conversion could be done by a single compiler. That means taking a high level language, converting it into first assembly language, and from assembly language transforming it into machine level language. So the flow of conversion is always like this. High level language, it goes to assembly. From assembly, it comes into machine level language. Now example of popular compiler which you are going to use is the GNU GCC C compiler, which has a built-in compiler for C, C++, Fortran and so on. We will be taking a look at the compiler in a subsequent session. Now some languages like BASIC, Perl, Python, do not actually use a compiler. They tend to use a software called as an interpreter. In the next slide, I'll explain what is the difference between a compiler and an interpreter. For now, you can think of an interpreter as a software or a system software which takes a program written in a high-level language and executes the instructions one at a time by converting each line into a machine-level language one at a time without having to convert the entire program into an object code. So this will be clear when I compare it in the next slide. So what it does is it takes lines of a program written in high level language, it converts it into object code or machine level language, executes that line, then it reads the next line, okay, again converts it into object code or machine level language, and then again executes it. This process is repeated until either the program is completed running or when the first error is encountered, the interpreter will stop doing its job. Whereas the compiler is a little different. It will take the program written in a high level language, convert it completely into object code, and then only it will be linked and loaded into the main memory, and from there it will run. Okay, so if a compiler is trying to, if you are using a compiler to convert a C program into object code, it will compile or translate the entire program, list all the errors, okay, or only when there are no errors, it will allow you to run that particular program. Now let's try to understand the difference between a compiler and an interpreter. This is a very common question asked in Viva. Okay. So what is the difference between a compiler and an interpreter? Again, these are major differences. We are not going into the very technical details. What a compiler does is it takes the complete program. Assume this thing is your entire program. Okay, this, or take these lines. All these lines are your, each one of them assume is one instruction. It will take all of this, convert it into machine language. Okay, and then allows the linking and loading to happen and run the code. Whereas an interpreter will take this first line, convert it into object code and allow you to run that first line. Then it will take the second line, convert it into machine code and execute. Suppose in the third line there is error, it will stop. Okay, so it will still have executed first and second. Whereas if you had done this with a compiler, it would have not compiled itself, because at the third line of interpreter, it would have landed into an error and it would have halted. So until you correct the error, it would have not allowed you to execute the entire thing. So compiler requires the complete thing to be correct before it can execute. Interpreter, even if the first 3, 4, or 1 or 2 lines are correct, it will execute at least the 1 or 2 lines. All right. Compiled programs will generally run much faster. There is a reason, because I have taken all these lines, converted into machine language, put it in the main memory, and it is going to run like automatic car. Whereas here what I am doing is every time along with my source program, I am also loading the interpreter. The interpreter is taking one line, converting it into object code, taking the second line, converting it into the object code. Since it has to do it for one line at a time, every time it has to convert and then execute, whereas this fellow has completed the conversion already, this is going to run faster and this is going to run comparatively slower. This will produce a complete list of errors and warning at one shot. This will halt at the first error. It will not allow you to proceed further. Advantage of this is you can compile this once and run it on that machine as many times as you want. Every time you want to run, you will require the source code and the interpreter together to run it. Because there is no executable ready, you will have to take the source code or the program written in high level language and each time use the interpreter to execute it line by line. Languages which are compiled are C, C++. Languages which are interpreted are Java, Python, Perl, etc. So I hope this gives you an idea about assembler, compiler and interpreter. In the next session, we shall talk about the linker and loader. Until then, goodbye.